Hello again. We'll be covering problem 5-36. That's from chapter 5 in the Horngren 14th edition. Please take a moment to read through and preview that problem to get a handle on just the nature of the problem in general before we jump into it. I have set up a little template of such here. That we're going to use. The first two columns represent the information given in Pumpkin Bag's budget for the year. The cost and they total up to a little bit over $1.5 million for the two products they produce. First requirement is that we look at each of these costs and identify which of the levels of the hierarchy that these costs may fall into, the cost categories. We know that a unit level cost is a cost associated with one product, or sometimes referred to as an output level cost. The direct costs are always associated with one product. We can clearly identify which materials go into purses, which go into backpacks, and which go into for the labor, which go into purses and which go into backpacks as well. The direct labor and the direct material items are always considered unit level cost. So these four here are going to be unit level. The title of this column, it's probably not appropriate, so I'm going to widen this just a little bit, and we'll label these unit level for all four of these. The goal is to identify to which portion of the company or the cost objects do each of these cost most directly, although many of them are indirect, most closely spent for. Why do we spend cost in setups? We spend cost in setups because they pertain to each batch. And so setups will always be a batch cost. When we spend money on setups, the cost of total setups increases with the number of batches that increases. Shipping is a tricky one. The best way to get a handle on the type of cost level is to make sure that you understand the company's nature of its industry and how it operates. It tells us that when completed, each batch of products is immediately shipped. So shipping costs are associated with batches of products. Sometimes, like Amazon, when customers order items, they're associated with specific units of product. Design relates to designing particular products or product lines. This is a product sustaining cost. Goes beyond just one batch and includes all the batches of a particular product or product line. And finally, we have plant utilities and administration, which is a cost associated with the facility itself, the factory. So these are facility sustaining cost. Now, why do we need to do this? We could still do calculations for ABC without, for ABC problems in an accounting class per se, without understanding the nature of each cost. But in order for us to identify a cost driver, which most homework problems already do for you, we need to identify to what items within a company do each of these costs pertain. Given the nature of our problem here, problem number 36, I believe, given the nature of problem number 36, we have been given some drivers that can be associated with these. And that's our next requirement, requirement two, identify the most appropriate cost driver. Our second table in the problem provides the cost drivers for us. Direct amounts, we know, are unit level cost. And being unit level cost, they're associated with particular units of product. The materials are associated with purses. Some materials are associated with backpacks. Same thing for labor. So the cost objects here are the purses and the backpacks. Setups. Thinking about how a company spends money on setups, it spends money only when it has an additional batch and it must reset up the machinery. Setups are associated with the number of batches. We already decided that. That also helps us pick out the driver, which is number of batches. What we're going to do is put in the drivers here, but we're going to put the drivers in based on the number of units of the particular driver. So if the driver here, for purses, for direct materials as purses, we have 3,350. For backpacks, there are 6,050 backpacks. And we have the same numbers here again for the labor associated with those. Note that we want the total that's associated with that particular cost. Setups, we just decided, are associated with batches. We have setups both for backpacks and purses, so we add the two together and we get 190 possible setups. Shipping is associated with batches as well. So we again use 190. Design is associated with products. There are two designs for backpacks and two for purses. So there's a total of four. Plant utilities is associated with the facility, production facility itself. And the closest driver that we see listed there would be hours of production. Company budgeted 4,050 hours of production. There are two ways to look at problems when we come up with rates. Some problems are budgeted types of problems, and that's what this problem is here. Other problems are after the fact, and if that is so, you will have both budgeted or estimated amounts and actual amounts given to you. Recalling what we did back in job costing, we took the rate and we multiplied it by the actual activity. This is a budgeted problem, so we have no actual activity. So once we determine the rate, we multiply it by the budgeted activity. Let's now put a little division sign here. And we're going to go through these and calculate the rates. The rates are calculated by taking the budgeted cost divided by the budgeted cost driver, in this case, purses. So we divide these up. We get 113.22. And we go all the way down our list and continue to divide these up to come up with the rates. The last four rates have 0 cents, so I'm going to delete the decimals in these. But the first four have decimals. In fact, if we add a few more decimals, you'll see that these aren't clear rounding at two decimal places. Fortunately, Excel keeps all the decimal places here, even though I am able to display only two decimals. I've identified each of the rates. Now I need to apply the activity and assign the cost to the particular items. Assigning includes both tracing cost and allocating cost. Direct cost here are traced. What I first need to come up with as it relates to number four, the requirement number four, is the total cost assigned to backpacks and the total cost assigned to purchases. I know that the materials assign to, oh, wrong one. The materials assigned to purses in total is 379. Another way to assign that would be to take the rate times the driver, and I should get the same amount. Materials for backpacks, 412,920. Labor for purses is 98,000, and labor for backpacks, 120,000. Now we get to the indirect cost. The costs that are more difficult to trace, in fact, we can't even trace these feasibly, so we're going to have to allocate these costs. These costs are less easy to assign because of their nature of being indirect. We know the activity rate is $347, and it's helpful to assign or to label that so we remember what we're going to multiply that 347 by. This is a rate per setup. This tells us every time we incur one setup for each of the two products, we should assign $347. How many did we incur for backpacks? Back to our problem, the second table. Backpacks have 130 batches. So we multiply 130 times the 347. So out of this 65,000, we're going to assign about $45,000 to backpacks. We're going to do the same thing for purses. The number of batches of purses is 60. We're going to assign $347 times the 60 batches, $20,820. Shipping. When we identified the cost driver, we came up with 190, which was the amount of batches. So this tells us, in fact, up here, we'll put batch and then setup in parens. And this one again is per batch, and more specifically, the number of shipping batches that exist. We have the same numbers, 130 and 60, because we're using the same cost driver for these. So 130 batches times 389 per batch, 50,570 is going to be assigned to backpacks. 60 setups or 60 batches times 389 assigns 23,340 to purses. Every time we do one design, we incur about $41,500. There were two designs for backpacks and two designs for purses. So this is per design. I multiply 2 times 41,5 and we assign 83,000 to backpacks. We assign exactly the same amount to purses. Each had 2. Finally, we are down to plant utilities and administration. Plant utilities and administration are allocated at $60 per hour of production. For backpacks, we have 1,450 hours of production. For purses, 2,600 hours of production. We've decided it costs $60 per hour. So we'll assign $60 per hour of production times 1,450 cost drivers hours of production. For purses, we're going to assign 2,600 by $60 each. And now we add up each column, and this gives us the total cost for backpacks in total, for all the backpacks, and the total cost for all purchases. Now we need to divide by the number of backpacks. We produced or plan to produce 6,050 backpacks. We plan to produce 3,350 purses, given in the second table. Our unit cost is total cost divided by number of units, $132 each for backpacks, $227 for purses. I keep wanting to say purchases. The last requirement asks us to explain how we can use this information to reduce cost. We identify the cost that seemed to be pretty hefty. I noticed that design, $41,500, is a cost per design. Perhaps we can look at the design process itself and do some process engineering and reduce the cost, come up with some efficiencies. Shipping is also pretty expensive. Maybe we should look at combining units in batches together. Instead of two batches of a particular product, create just one batch. We could do the same thing for setups here. If we combine or increase the number of units in each batch, we can save us $347 for each batch that we reduce. Materials seem like they're very expensive for purses, and you would think that a backpack would contain more materials than a purse. So maybe we can look at possible inefficiencies in dealing with the purses and the materials that are consumed. And both labor seem to be, on a relative basis, what we'd expect, more labor for backpacks than for purses. This concludes problem number 36.